that a reader lives 1,000 lives. A person who does not read lives only one. The thing that keeps you from becoming a master or on that path of mastery are these words saying, oh, I know that already. It's like, oh, I know that already, something else. But the masters really get good at the basics and the fundamentals because that's everything. The question I would ask all the time was, how can I make this better? Because I was obsessed. And the key to reading comprehension is asking more questions. If you read a page in a book, get to the end, and not get anything out of it, it's because you're not asking questions, because questions are the answer. But that's all thinking is. When you really break down functionally what thought and thinking is, when you're in a corner thinking to yourself, you're asking questions, and then you're answering them. Why must I use this? Because here's the thing. The biggest lie in the personal development industry is that knowledge is power. It's just you feel like you got points because you signed up for a seminar or a webinar, you bought a book and it sits on your shelf. The truth is, what people don't tell you is all the podcasts, coaching, conferences, online programs, none of it works unless you work.
You could have a lot of information in your job because a lot of us, we're not paid necessarily for our muscle power, it's more our mind power. It's not our brute strength, but it's really this age, it's our brain strength. And knowledge is not only power, it's profit. And I don't mean financial profit, that's obvious, right? The faster you can learn, the faster you can earn in today's economy. But I mean all the treasures of your life, because when you can learn how to learn, you can apply that towards your relationships, towards your wellness, towards your career. The greatest advantage, competitive, sustainable advantage in a world full of fast change is our ability to be able to absorb, to be able to assimilate, to be able to apply new information. And that really comes down to really understanding how our mind works. And so I am obsessed with solving this riddle of how does my brain work so I can work my brain. I see this on social media a lot. They'll complain about being burnt out, or they'll complain about being tired. And I don't think necessarily in every case that we're burnt out or tired because we're doing too much, but maybe we're doing too little of the things that really matter, that make us feel alive. And I always talk about the most important thing is to keep the most important thing the most important thing. If you're climbing the ladder of success and you get all the way to the top and you realize it's leaning on the wrong wall, better to know earlier than later. And so beginning with the end in mind, it's kind of like this idea where you go fast forward all the way to when we're taking our last breaths. And at that time, nobody's opinions or our fears, none of that's going to matter. What's going to matter is how we lived, how we loved, how we laughed, how we learned.
And you know what a question I ask a lot of is like, who's counting on me to win today? First, because some of you, and I bring this up because some of you really will do more for other people than you will for yourself. So knowing that about yourself, self-awareness is a superpower, then tap into that. You don't have to change it, tap into it. Who's counting on me to like be at my best? And then you're more likely to do it. And you want to start with your why, because reasons reap results. Reasons reap results. And even remembering people's names, if you don't have a reason to remember their name, you don't. This is the thing, you don't remember everyone's name, but you sure as heck don't forget everyone's name either. And I bet you the names you remember are people that you have some kind of intention. You're attracted to that person. They could be good for your business, right? That something, there's some kind of motivation that's there. So find your motivation in your reading, because if you're not motivated, you're not gonna read very well. You know, so everything could teach you something. And we know that the problems that we have in life are teachers also as well. Like I have had, we all have had serious issues in different areas of our life. You ask yourself, quite remember, questions are the answer. Where's the lesson in this? Right? Your greatest teacher is your last mistake, right? That's the power of going out there making mistakes. And here's the thing, a lot of people won't be willing to make mistakes, including trying to learn something brand new, like a speed reading, because their fear of messing up and not being perfect at something, right? And they feel that that can be successful. But you know in your life, whether it's your career, whether it's your health or relationship or anything, that if failure is not an option, then neither is success. That's what we're here to be able to do. That the ultimate quest in life really is to reach our fullest potential, to express that potential, to be able to share that potential with others.
If you knew how truly powerful your mind was, you wouldn't say, think, or feel something you didn't want to be true. And that's not to say you have one negative thought and it ruins your life any more than eating that donut every once in a while does, but it's the consistency. And I've reflected on this a lot, that when you're first born, we're a blank slate, right? There's nothing there until we have an experience and we try to avoid the pain. And so we come up with these global general beliefs about things that protect us. And so what I would say for this is, that's why I think practices of mindfulness they're so important, because it brings us in the moment. Know that our thoughts aren't who we are necessarily. But you've heard me say this, when people come to me all the time at any event, and I just gave a talk recently, and people say things like, Jim, I have a horrible memory, or I'm getting too old, or I'm not smart enough. And I always tell people, if you fight for your limitations, you get to keep them, right? And you have to be careful and mindful of these thoughts. And that's why I think journaling is an important tool. Meditation is an important tool, because it sensitizes you to this inner talk. Our focus is very much like a muscle. It grows stronger with use. We're not feeding our focus, we're feeding our distractions, and that muscle is getting stronger. But the good news is we have control and we have responsibility. And the goal is just not to be running old scripts, to be conscious. I think the meta message of this conversation is that we are not our thoughts.
So three questions. How can I use this? Why must I use this? When will I use this? Three powerful questions that lead to something which I think the number one productivity performance tool there is your calendar. Because a lot of you say you want to work out, or you want to meditate, or you want to do this self-care, and you know self-love and self-care is not selfish, and you know all this stuff, but how does your daily calendar reflect that? Because I can look at anyone's calendar and see like where they are in life because of what they prioritize, first things first. And the number one regret I hear ongoing for two decades of doing this is that somehow they live their life for somebody else in some area of their life. Many of us are gonna be in a coffin, we're gonna be in a box, and in that box, there's not a lot of room for possessions. And if you have cars and everything, that's wonderful, but there's certainly not a lot of room for regrets. Because here's the thing, if you buy into the opinions of other people, you're gonna go broke, right? If you're looking to be fueled by other people's expectations and opinions of yourself, then you're gonna run out of gas, right? That if you're going through difficult times, they can define you, they could diminish you, or they could develop you, but you decide. And it always comes back to decision. So prompting you with these three questions, how can I use this?